Hello and welcome to another Minecraft tutorial. I'm going to be showing you how to set up a server and I'm going to start a bit of a series in this. And I'm going to be using Log Me In Hamachi because that's the easiest and safest way to set up a server. I'm going to be downloading Hamachi from CNET because they're quite a secure and simple download. So the first step is to click download now, and it's a CNET secure download. So just wait till it downloads. Okay, so Hamachi's download. All you need to do is open it and click run. Choose your language, click next, read the terms and conditions, I've already done that, and then choose where you want it and click install. If it asks if you want to let it make changes, just click yes, because I've used Hamachi a lot of times on different computers and it's definitely safe and it's definitely worth it. And then just click finish. So Hamachi will come up like this, just click the power button and then choose a client name. This is for your computer and people will be able to see it if you're connected to their group. So I'm going to go with Tom PC. So after a bit of a wait, you'll come to this. Then you can choose to create a new network or join an existing one. You'll also be able to do this if you go into the network tab. And so if you make a new network, you're going to need to select an ID and a password. So you create the network, and then if you tell your friends the ID and password, they'll be able to connect to your network as well. And then you'll be able to create groups. I'm not sure what the maximum size is, but then you can do Minecraft servers together. And also there's the first number up there, or you can just click IPv4, which is the address that you're going to need to put in your Minecraft server. So now we're going to start making the server. The first thing you do is close Hamachi, and I recommend making a new folder on your desktop. And I'm just going to call it server. Now go into Internet Explorer or whatever you have and just search Minecraft. Then click download, or you can go to minecraft.net and then click download here. And then Minecraft server you want to go. So you need to download that. It shouldn't take very long. And then drag it to your new folder. It only has that number next to it because I've downloaded a lot of these Minecraft servers. So if you have a number, just get rid of it. So double click the server now, and after a bit of a while it should start up. And so I'm going to skip to when it's done. Here we go, and so now the Minecraft server has finished loading and you can just close that now. So then you'll come back to here, and there's a server properties file. What you want to do is open with and then select Notepad, which will be in the other programs tab, or you might have to browse for it. So select Notepad and then you'll come up with this. These are the settings on the server. I'm going to go through each one. Allow Nether is whether you want to allow people to go to the Nether or not. The world name is simply the name of the world, so you could change it to World 1 if you wanted to. I'm not 100% sure what Enable Query does. Allow Flight is whether you want to let people use the Fly mod or not. You need this if you're going to make your server a Planes server, but you need the plain mod for that. Server port, you don't have to change, so I'd just leave it like that if I were you. Level type, again, I wouldn't change that, though if you want super flat, just type super flat in capitals. I don't know what an enable archon is. Level seed, you probably know what seeds are in Minecraft. Server IP, we'll get to that in a minute. Max build height, I don't know if you can change that, though. If you can, just change it to whatever you want. Spawn NPCs is if you want NPCs to spawn. And then there's the same for animals as well. Whitelist is if you want to have a list of people that are allowed on the server, and so if you're not on the list, you're not on the server. Online mode you need to put to false if you haven't paid for Minecraft, or you want to let people who haven't paid for Minecraft on your server. PvP is if you want to let people hurt each other. Difficulty is the difficulty of your server. I think 1 might be easy, but I'm not sure. And then game mode you can change to 1 if you want everyone to be creative on the server. Max players is the max number of players. You can pretty much set that to whatever you want. Spawn monsters is if you want monsters to spawn. Generate structures is if you want things like NPC villages. The view distance I wouldn't change because that can mess it up. And then the mod D is just a description of your server. So if you change anything, do file, save, and then close it. The whitelist, you just put the names of the people on if you click enable whitelist in here. Ops is the list of people that you want to be in charge on the server, and that they can do commands like they can spawn items or they can change the time of day. The server file is just some stuff that you don't need to have a look at, though it will say when people are banned and things like that, so you can look at this to find out who banned who and stuff like that. Banned players, you put the names of players you don't want to be on your server, and banned IPs is the list of IPs you don't want. World is just the world, and if you want to change it, you can go to percentage, app data percentage, go to .minecraft, and then if you've got any worlds that you want in here, you can change the world file to this. So the way I'd do that is I'd rename this world just like that, and then you can delete that one and put that in there instead. So now you need to go back to Hamachi, and you'll see that you've got a serve, you've got an IP there. You just do copy IPv4 address, and then if you go to the server properties file, you can paste it in server IP. So now let's try out the server. So just get it. It's useful to have this server thing up if something goes wrong, and double click Minecraft server. So when it's done, just start up Minecraft. So when you go here, you need to paste the server address in the server address box. To do that, you go to Hamachi, you go copy IPv4 address, which you can do if you click there, and then just do Control V, click Done. So the server that we just created is now on. It says 0 out of 9,000 players because I made it 9,000, the maximum player. Just click Join Server. So we're in my server. Looks like we're drowning at the start, so let's just get some land. Though, so if you want other people to join, they have to join your Hamachi group, and then you can just tell them the server IP and they'll be able to join your server by doing the same thing that you did to join the server. Thanks for watching. Please like or subscribe if you found this video helpful or you used it to make your own server.